What is up, guys? Welcome back to Let's Play Phoenix Wright
Ace Attorney.
With me, TapersCrazy. Well, let's left off. We got through the first day of court. There was a lot of questions being asked. Bruce Goodman got killed twice in the... Got killed twice at the same time. One in the police department and one in his car. And I told you my theory last episode, but I'll just recap. I think Bruce Goodman got killed in the police department and then transported in the back of Edgeworth's car here, which is why there's no blood, not a lot of blood here. So that's what I'm thinking. But we'll just continue on by talking to this crazy lady. Let's go on.
Today's trial.
You certainly put me in a tight spot today.
My apologies, Miss Starbuck.
No, it's okay. It was my fault. Oh, we know. I witnessed everything from that security room right there. But I was afraid that wouldn't sound convincing enough, you see. I was wrong to think that. I'm sorry. Sorry, you lied on the witness stand. That's unforgivable.
Ooh, who should? Little girl, don't forget what's important here. Even if the place where I witnessed the events was different, I still saw what I saw. I saw Chief Prosecutor Sky stab a man in cold blood, and that testimony still stands.
Oh, shit.
Ah!
I swear it on my honor as a detective. She stabbed Goodman. And I want to skin 100 puppies. 101 Dalmatians. I know this photograph is something important to tell us, but what?
Photograph. Oh, she took the photograph. Oh, no! Is that where the knife came from? I get the feeling, right, okay, that Detective Goodman got stabbed in the police department by a different knife. Then he got shipped over here in Edgeworth's car. I don't know how I've got through the police department with that on, but it was an award ceremony on, so everyone will have been in that. And then, for some reason, whatever, I don't know why, Lana will have came here and put a different knife in the body. And that's why it's wrong, because that's how the knife got there. She saw Lana put the knife in, and that's irrefutable evidence. But Goodman was already dead.
I need evidence. Detective Star.
So, you're a detective, aren't you, Miss Star? Yes, it was a long time ago. Well, 2 years ago. No matter how hard I'm the criminal, when they faced me...
They cuffed it up. Coughed it up? What? What have you been doing with them? No, you must not be going under the table. What are you? They confessed.
They babbled like babies. You know, I may seem like a demon sometimes, but I can be an angel too.
I wouldn't doubt it.
Every day I jerk the dirt out of the mouths of suspect after suspect. And before long they called me...
The Cuff of Queen.
More like the Demon Queen. She's gonna sprout wings and fly out through the door.
Fly, my pretty! Fly! Oh, and here I thought someone had gotten food poisoning from your lunches.
And you were let go, fired.
She was fired.
I felt that I found my dream job when I became an investigator. And if these prim and proper prosecutors hadn't let me go, I'd still be one today.
Okay, so she has got a grudge for sure.
It's all because of that case. VSL9 incident.
Oh, and that's tied to this case as well, so...
SL... Wait, she doesn't mean.
Present... Shall I present VSL9 ticket? Shall I present this thing?
What do you think about this?
VSL9 incident. On that knife.
And on that note... Goodman was the head detective of that case, you know. Really? That knife was evidence from that case, the murder weapon.
Oh dear. Well, I suppose that's it's not really anything else, is it?
It was due for transfer for the very day that Goodman was killed. As I suspected. SL9 isn't over. Not yet.
Do you think you can tell us more about the SL9 incident?
Yes, please. We need this information, man. Tell us more about the SL9 incident. So present the knife, I suppose?
Tell us.
What do you think about this? SL9 incident.
SL9 incident. We need to find more about SL9, so why is she not telling us about it?
I had one of those until 2 years ago. Back when you were Coffer Queen, right?
We found his ID card here in his parking lot.
Well, there's no mistaking that. It's definitely Goodman's.
But it's the same ID as Emmanuel's girl at the police department.
That's impossible.
I wish I could be so sure.
Okay, so we need to get sure about this actually being Goodman in two places at the same time. Let's do his trophy. Edgar's knife. The badger panel. Autopsy report. Goodman's note. Crime photo. Victim shoes. Switchblade knife. Contesting.
Present this. Could you take a look at this?
You.
Yes.
You said you wanted some hot tea, right?
No, but thanks. She didn't even look at it. Okay, let's go to Edgeworth's room and see what he's got to say. February 23rd, High Prosecutor's Office. Room 1202.
Well, this place is certainly tidy today.
And it will be tidy tomorrow, too. Incidentally, he's not here. He's probably busy.
I'm sure he's off doing important investigations.
I hope that's what he's doing.
Huh?
I guess we'll have to come back.
Okay, let's have another move around. Screw the Coffer Queen, she's not telling me anything about this online incident. I think I need something new to present to her for that one.
To the detention center. Maybe Lana Sky will talk to us today. February 23rd, detention center. Visitor's room. Looks like Miss Sky is in questioning.
I hope detectives aren't yelling at her. How did you kill him in two places at the same time? Can you imagine?
How is she supposed to answer that? Wait a second. The chief said they called the criminal in the police department.
Let's come back later.
Yes. They caught him to the police department. Go to the first department. February 23rd. Police department. Criminal affairs. Wow, everyone looks deadly serious here.
Well, there was a vicious murder of a detective in this department, after all.
Yes, but the same detective also killed at the same time in prosecutor's lot.
Oh, makes my head hurt.
Well, first things first. I want to check out the crime scene here.
Yes, you should. You sound dead set on investigating.
Dude, too soon. Too soon.
But don't mess up, or you could wind up dead.
You know, I don't know what small mysteries or dead bodies around here right now. But it doesn't look like anyone's going to help us much either.
Can we go into the evidence room? Police department entrance.
February 23rd. Police department entrance. It's even busier today than it was yesterday.
The detectives are running around so fast they're blurring.
I suppose it makes sense. The detective did get killed in their own departments.
So, the evidence room, the scene of a crime. According to the pamphlet we got at the front desk, here it is.
She's like getting an amusement park.
Ooh, a real crime scene. Let's go take a look.
Can we even go there? Security guard office. what?
I wonder whose office this is. Invert evidence room entrance guard station.
Has it got like a little chat though?
What's with the decor in this place? It's very eccentric.
According to the pamphlet, this is the guard station for the evidence room.
So beyond that door is the evidence room, the scene of a crime.
It sure seems that way. Oh!
What's wrong?
It's those cacti! They're so prickly, so imposing. It's hard to think straight.
If you can't handle cacti, stay out of the desert. What I want to know is, if this is a guard station, where is the guard?
I have a feeling I know who this guard is already.
So do I. Okay, so can we move in there? Oh.
Examine the door so we can enter.
Whoop.
The evidence room is beyond that door.
Let's just walk in. It won't open.
You thought it'd be open. I think we need someone's permission to go in there first.
Okay, so can we miss about, what about this thing?
Look on the floor, a lasso!
Looks like it's set up to trap something.
A trap? Here? Wait, I know! Maybe someone's trying to catch a wild bull in here.
A bull?
But the lasso missed!
You sure have an active imagination.
And these things.
There's a security guard uniform hanging there.
Looks more like a costume than a uniform, honestly.
A leather jacket, leather pants, a leather... What was that called again? A punchy? A punchy? A pinchy? I know, a poochie!
A what?
Wait, maybe that wasn't it.
It's a poncho, but I think I'll keep the information to myself for the time being.
Yeah, it is funny. Okay, so he's not here, is he? Okay, what about this gate?
This swinging door makes the place look like some kind of saloon.
But look, it's nailed shut. You can't get in that way.
Of course not. If you went in through here, the cactus would fall over. Ouch!
I say it'd be more of a... myself.
Okay. So we need to go get it.
Where's Gumshoe?
Okay, let's go to the police department entrance.
Let's have a look around then, shall we?
If you think about it, I could have taken that picture from the guard room. But even I get flustered sometimes.
So you went straight to the scene of a crime?
I'm climbing the chain link fence in an effort to stop the murder.
Oh, wait. So that wasn't a picture of Lana Sky stabbing me? Oh, okay.
That's when I took this photo, yes. In other words, 5 minutes after the crime? Those 5 minutes have a whole problem. A hole in my testimony, as it were. The 5 minutes weren't the problem, Mr. You lying was the problem. Listen, little girl. I've had my testimony disregarded before, and I wasn't going to have it disregarded again. Just like that time.
That time?
That time. Come on, talk to us about it.
There we go. Jesus Christ.
That's when I learned the truth. Where nothing's of them. Disposable. Disposable? 2 years ago, it was the biggest case I'd ever handled.
Who the frick is that then?
So that's Goodman. That looks like that cowboy. That's, who's this guy?
The police and the prosecutors were desperate for decisive evidence. So they didn't solve it. On the contrary, it was solved quite cleanly. The criminal was caught and... Executed? Yes, the criminal got what was coming to him. It doesn't get any clearer than that. The only problem was, they never did find decisive evidence. Not even a little.
What? But the criminal was executed, right?
Evidence. Of a sort. Made up evidence.
What?
You mean, they executed someone with fabricated evidence?
Oh shit. No wonder everyone got freaking fired then.
The best part came several months after the trial. Every detective involved in the case was dealt with. Some were demoted to patrolmen, others found themselves out of a job. And you were one of those. Myself and one other person you know well.
Wait, could it be?
Exactly, Officer Jake Marshall. He's on security detail in the police department, isn't he? Isn't he?
Is it Detective Marshall?
As professional detectives, we investigated our case from every angle.
Okay.
Jake was particularly determined, and then it was over, and he was demoted.
Oh, shit.
However, he hasn't forgotten, and neither have I.
You haven't forgotten SL9?
There was another side to our case, a hidden side. That's what we're after now. And no one up in their fancy offices can't stop us. Wait! Those lunches you sell! There is only one reason I come to sell lunches in this accursed office. I come here to meet all friends. Boyfriends that can help me investigate.
Miss Star's old boyfriends. How many did she have, anyway? A few. She's had many penises in her lifetime. Just when it is on the case I've disappeared, we find new evidence.
There has to be a connection. So, Rookie.
What?
Seems like you're serious about investigating this case.
Yes.
Okay.
Then you should take this.
A Salisbury steak lunch.
I know a certain guy who might help you if you tempt him with his treat.
Salisbury steak is known in the West, isn't it?
Miss Starr, Officer Marshall, is he your, going out? Why do you want to know? I was just wondering what happened to him. A long time ago, when he was helping my sister do cases, he was so nice. He got along so well with my sister, it made me jealous. And he was nice to me too back then.
This will be when Officer Marshall was a detective.
But now he's so cold. Jake and I are merely cooperating on this investigation. We're putting the past to rest, as it were. Nothing more than that. I see. Thank you.
Officer Jake Marshall.
Okay, so we've got everything out of a cough up queen.
We made the cough up queen cough up.
Okay. Maybe he's back at the security office then.
Police department. Entrance. This place is charged with frantic energy as always.
Please!
Was it that?
One sec lunch, please. Oh, it's you. expensive gumshoe. Now it's not time for chit-chat, pal. I'm a busy man. What I really need is a steak lunch from Lunchland.
Oh, you mean one of these? Actually, it's not for sale.
Oh dear.
I think I deserve a sound of his heart breaking. Now it's no time for despair. We've caught our criminal. Now we just need evidence. The criminal? You mean... You heard about stabbing in the police department. Evidence room, pal. Yes, I was there when we talked about it. On the same day of the dead who was killed in the prosecutor's parking lot, a new detective was killed in the police department.
I'm a perpetrator. Do you have a suspect?
Well, there was a suspect. Just the rest of them, in fact.
Just the rest of them?
Oh. It's the biggest scandal that hit the station in ages. Everything's topsy-turvy. But Detective Gumshoe, who was it? Listen, pal. All I know is that I need me a steak lunch. Pronto. Staying around here, Tony, is gonna fill my belly.
But wait, don't leave.
If you want no more, hell into the detention center, pal. Crisis should be over, so I think these down there having a good cry. Later.
Oh, okay.
Here and after the evidence room.
Well, this investigation is off to a running start.
Okay. So now where do we go? So it wants me to go to the... What's it called? The detention center. Okay.
February 23rd, detention center. Visitor's room.
Still, I do feel better about things. A little. I mean, they caught a person who stabbed Steve Goodman, didn't they?
Yeah. I guess they did. Best not go too far down that road right now. Things will just get confusing. Oh!
What the hell?
Well, what was that?
Sir, that's what I'm saying. Me and your perpetrator. I was on for dinner, sir. That's what I say.
Oh, Meekins.
Oh, hi, greetings, sir. Message for you, sir.
Wait, I know who you are.
Meekins.
Excuse me, my name is Mr. Redshipper. Anyone who prepares this? I'm here, sir. I have a real refugee, sir. I've got your report, sir.
Officer Meekins, so you're a guard here at the detention center?
No, sir, I'm not, sir. I'm really lost patrolman like a lost lamb, sir.
Oh, I get it. You're here to deliver a report.
No, sir, I'm here. How should I say this?
Wait, he isn't. Is he? You, Officer Meekins, you didn't. Did you?
Perpetrator Officer Meekins reporting, sir.
What? What?
Now, this is an unexpected turn of events. Meekins?
How can he stab anyone? What is going on here? Okay, what is he doing with his hands like?
I'm in a Boy Scout, sir!
The day of a crime.
Sir, I'm a trauma of Jared Fraser! Sir!
Oh! I can hear you fine, Officer Meekins!
That's a bit of an answer! Sir, I'm in the evidence room, sir! The guard of the infirmary room was empty, sir!
So, now there's a guard of the evidence room!
That's right, sir! There's evidence kept in the evidence room, sir! No, the security officer! What's that of an officer, Marshall?
Marshall?
Man, sir, I am in a class of a security room monitor! That's when I saw him, sir! Is this a suspicious person in the evidence room? A suspicious person! Is everybody here? A suspicious person!
What the heck is this guy doing? Oh god, this guy's destroying my voice!
So, what happened then?
Adventure, everything went white! I saw red! I ran out! And when I came to, I was here! In the detention center!
Wait, what? No. Because the murder was yesterday. But he still came to see Edgeworth. After the murder happened, so he couldn't have woke up here.
That's impossible!
How long were you out? Days?
Might I ask? What happened to your hand?
Sir, there was no one to bandage me, sir! So anyway, I could have grabbed up, sir!
A bandage on his hand? Just like Miss Sky. Damn, Miss Sky.
Yeah, no slurs for me, Miss Please. I'm the one of Prescott's office.
First things first. Tell us how you hurt your hand.
Okay, fair enough.
Under your hand. But I haven't been able to come on stabbed.
What is it, sir?
Don't think you should just confess.
Was there? Sir? What? There's nothing I could do.
Nothing you could do?
Sir, it's helped you. Sir, what happened? You intend to point that knife at me. I just hollered, sir. The next thing I knew, I was unconscious.
The next thing you knew, you were, huh?
Then, when you opened my eyes. There was no one in the evidence room, sir. All alone. Alone because the little woman had disappeared.
So he wasn't there.
But when I did, I was squishing blood from my head, sir. Oh, Chuck. Oh, the sorcerer. Can you imagine how I felt?
Miss Boyce.
The victim's body disappeared.
That's some story.
Okay, I think I should have done voice in order, but you know.
I don't mean to pry, but I... You are the perpetrator, Chris. You killed Dante Bruce coming in the earnest room, right?
Sir, I saw me almost type of down, sir. If you have to name me as a person, good enemy, sir. But not me, victim.
I will, but you have to be in attention and alive and well at that.
Yes. Oh, that's true, sir. I suppose you could say that.
Did you know the victim, Detective Goodman?
Well, sir, if your name is a stranger or a total stranger, but I say your name is definitely on the total stranger side.
So, you didn't know him?
Sir, I work in a town department devoid of land or of a creature comforts. I don't know any detectives.
So, if he was a total stranger, why did you stab him?
Sir, I didn't know Detective Goodman, sir. None. No, do I have any recollection of killing him, sir.
Ah, blocked nose. Oh dear. At least someone around here is a lot more confused than I am.
Shit, so there's anything you can present for him? Not for now. I guess we shall go back to the evidence room. We'll have to go to a police entrance. Bloody hell, it's like a bloody maze navigating around these screens. Jesus Christ. Who's in this?
Officer Meekins, this is for you.
Let's go to night, sir.
It's okay, I just want you to take a look at it.
Was that, sir? Last night, sir? That's what? It was an apple, sir. In my dream, sir. And I was being peeled.
On second thought, you didn't have to look at the knife.
He's overreacting to the knife, but I guess he's been through a lot. What about this? My ace attorney's badge. Officer Meekins, have a look at this.
Go ahead, sir. Left me, sir.
Oh, wait, what?
I know what you want to say. You're going to tell me how she has one just like it.
But me? Why would I?
I know, sir. I know. I'm the only one with a girl with matching badges. Nowhere. I'm alone. All alone. Is that so wrong? Let's talk about high school sweethearts and you for romance, sir.
Is he talking about those badges on her coat? I like to admit there's a difference between my badge and a fashion accessory.
Do you think you could take a look at this?
Hey! That's it, sir! That's it!
That's what?
My hair was blank on David's very moment! But sir, now I remember, sir!
You mean, you remember what happened?
Correct! A card of a card was caused of a doll!
This? ID card?
It's either, sir. But it's not yet. Nothing could be more intense or nothing.
You better pry into this one a little deeper. You've got the most annoying voice on planet Earth.
Crime details.
Can you tell me what it is you do remember?
Well, sir, you might say I'm a lesson for Truman. A lesson in lamb, if you will.
Okay.
I didn't know Mr. Truman was in the evidence room.
And that's why you thought he looked suspicious.
Sir, I ain't in the evidence room and asked a man to display his ID card.
Well, that sounds pretty much by the book so far.
But that's right, sir. That's what I've been trying to tell you.
So you asked that Truman to show his ID card. What did he do?
But the thing, suddenly pointed a knife at me.
What?
Sir, I assure you, I'm as fast as you are right now.
Shut up.
So I whooped and leapt at him.
Then the gunman pointed a knife at him.
Don't know us before we don't you. My own father's words, sir.
What happened then?
Well, my eyes, sir. Everything went white when I woke out here.
No, it wasn't. Was he?
Right. Reason for arrest.
So, Officer Meekins, why is it that they arrested you?
What do you mean, Emma?
Let's look at what we know. Now, Officer Meekins didn't know Detective Goodman, and the victim whom he met at the scene of a crime didn't show his ID card. In other words, we have no way of knowing if the victim was really the victim.
Oh, was it not Goodman? Oh, shit. She's got a point.
And if his body just disappeared from the evidence room, we don't even know if now she died.
But that's true, but that's what I want to say. But I did say something along those lines.
Huh?
Huh? But you still end up here.
I don't know, but it had to be him, sir. I'm not there for time. David Grimm was definitely in the evidence room. That's what they said.
So he was definitely in there.
But you don't remember events clearly.
No, but videotape is quite clear.
Huh? Videotape?
For the security camera. For Grandmaster Warren's camera. It's me, it's on tape.
Oh, that's good then.
Excellent.
And you went on that stuff with this?
I'm sorry, Mr. Officer. I love my badge. I don't deserve it.
No, 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 thanks. I have my own. Well, I guess better go check out the crime scene. And we shall do that in the next episode.
So, yeah. Thanks for watching this, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Red tight, subscribe, and I'll see you all
in the next video.